Hey guys, Sean Malawani here of BodyTransformationTruth.com, and in today's video I'm going to be doing a review of citrulline malate. So this supplement isn't nearly as popular in comparison to other performance boosting compounds like creatine or beta alanine or caffeine, but it has been gaining more and more credibility in recent years as an effective pre-workout ingredient for improving overall strength, endurance, and bottom line muscle growth. So I'll be covering what citrulline malate is, what it does, how to take it, possible side effects, as well as my top recommended product. So citrulline malate is a combination of the amino acid L-citrulline and malic acid, and there are two primary ways that it might benefit your program. The first is by reducing muscular fatigue during exercise. Citrulline assists in clearing out metabolic waste products such as ammonia and lactate during your workouts, and this should allow you to basically squeeze out additional reps on sets that use moderate to high reps. And in addition to that, it's also going to help you recover more quickly in between sets. And the second benefit is that it reduces post-workout muscle soreness, and this might improve overall recovery in between workouts. So if you're somebody who's on a higher frequency plan that has you training each specific muscle group twice a week or more, then this might improve your overall strength and performance if you do tend to get quite sore after training. And I will provide a link in the description box below to the most popular citrulline malate study available that clearly showed both of the benefits I just mentioned, both a significant increase in lifting performance and a reduction in post-workout muscle soreness. Citrulline malate is also marketed for its supposed ability to raise nitric oxide levels in the body, but I'm not quite convinced that this is a legitimate benefit that is going to carry over to your actual workouts. Citrulline malate does increase the levels of L-arginine in your blood, but arginine is not a limiting factor when it comes to nitric oxide production. In other words, your body already has enough L-arginine circulating in order to maximize its effects, and dumping a few extra grams of arginine on top of this is not likely going to make any significant difference when it comes to nitric oxide production or when it comes to your overall workout performance. So how much citrulline malate should you take and when? Well, based on the available research, the proper citrulline malate dosage in order to see optimal benefits is going to be between 6 to 8 grams. This can be mixed in whatever liquid you prefer based on your taste preference, and it should be taken anywhere from 30 to 45 minutes prior to your training session. Do keep in mind that citrulline malate does have a very strong sour taste to it, so you'll probably want to mix it in a flavored drink in order to mask this. In terms of side effects, the only known side effect of citrulline malate supplementation at this time is that it may cause stomach discomfort in a small percentage of users. And consuming your citrulline malate on an empty stomach is going to be the best way to reduce this effect. So who should supplement with citrulline malate? Well, I definitely wouldn't consider citrulline malate to be a must-have by any means, and also keep in mind that the actual concrete research on this supplement is still very limited. However, given that the available research that is out there does show measurable benefits, and given that the effects of citrulline malate do make sense on paper, and given that the real world feedback is usually positive in the majority of users, I would say that citrulline malate is a worthwhile supplement for you to experiment with if you already have the basics covered, first of all. So you can check out my complete fitness supplementation guide using the link in the description box below to find out which specific supplements that I consider to be foundational in a muscle building and fat loss program. And secondly, assuming that money is not an issue, because this stuff is not particularly cheap and it is quite a bit more expensive on a gram per gram basis in comparison to other popular supplements like creatine or beta alanine. And thirdly, because of the way that citrulline malate functions in the body, it's only going to primarily benefit those who are following a training program that involves moderate to higher reps, so at least 8 reps per set, shorter intervals in between sets, and a reasonably high workload per session and a reasonably high training frequency. If you're utilizing a plan that involves lower reps and longer resting intervals in between sets, then the effects of citrulline malate are going to be far less pronounced, though it might still be useful for its effects on reducing post-workout muscle soreness. And the final question here is, what is the best citrulline malate product available? So there are two main criteria that a high quality citrulline malate product should meet. The first criteria is that it should deliver a chemically bonded source of L-citrulline and malic acid. In other words, each molecule of L-citrulline is directly bonded to each molecule of malic acid, rather than simply having them dumped in and mixed together separately. And the second criteria is that it should provide a 2-to-1 ratio of L-citrulline to malic acid, rather than the 1-to-1 ratio that some companies use. I would also strongly recommend purchasing a pure citrulline malate powder and measuring out the dosage for yourself, rather than relying on commercial pre-workouts that simply include citrulline malate as part of the overall blend. The proper citrulline malate dosage, again, is going to be between 6 to 8 grams, and most of the popular pre-workout formulas on the market are not even going to come close to delivering this amount. So based on that criteria, I personally recommend Primaforce citrulline malate, which I will provide a link to in the description box, as it is a bonded source of citrulline malate and it is present in a 2-to-1 ratio. So my overall suggestion when it comes to citrulline malate is to take the potential benefits that I've outlined in this video into consideration, weigh it against the cost, and then decide if you think that it is a worthwhile supplement to try out based on your individual situation. And if you do decide to experiment with it, I'd be curious to hear your feedback. And if you have used it up to this point already, then you can go ahead and leave a comment below and let me know what your experience with it was. So thanks for watching this video. I hope you found the information useful here today. If you did enjoy the video, as always, please make sure to hit the like button, leave a comment, and subscribe to stay up to date on future videos. Also, make sure to check out my complete step-by-step muscle building and fat loss programs over at bodytransformationtruth.com by clicking the icon at the top of the video or using the link in the description box below. And make sure to check out my official blog over at seannell.com for all of my latest articles, tips, and other updates. Talk to you again soon.